So how many times would people be telling you, I love you, and they actually haven't loved you? They're just trying to get to you. They just want to use you. They will want to just have a little party with you. And next thing, they'll drop you out and they'll be telling another 50 girls at the same time the same thing. Yes, wallahi, it's happening. Ask the youth and they will tell you, true. Not true? Okay, they shy to nod their heads. You can nod them after the cameras leave, inshallah. May Allah forgive us, really. Do not do that. Do not abuse people. They are someone's sisters, someone's daughters, someone's mothers, someone's, for example, aunts and so on, just like you have. You would not like your relatives to be abused. Why are you abusing others? Quite simple. That is the hadith of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Today in the Western world, they are teaching you to say, don't abuse a female. Before abusing her, think for a moment, before getting there, before even thinking about that, you'd rather ponder over the fact that she is someone's sister. She could have been your sister. She is someone's mother. She is someone's daughter. Well, that's taken directly from the words of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He says, when a man came to him and told him, O messenger, I want to commit fornication. Wow. A'udhu billah. Then the LOL definitely stands for La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. Allahu Akbar. Imagine, he had the guts and the courage. Well, the message was for us. He did not commit it, but he said the word. Perhaps he might have had the idea and he wanted help. And this is why, my brothers and sisters, reach out for help. And oh, you who are helping others, do not abuse them. Allahu Akbar. Oh, you who are helping others, do not abuse them. Today we have a sickness where someone comes to you for help, whether it is financial help, whether it is any other form of help, and we abuse the status Allah has given us, the wealth Allah has given us, to try and lure them into sexual misconduct or something of that nature, abuse them in some way. May Allah forgive us, really. May Allah strengthen us. Where is the ummah heading? Come on, we need people who have values. We need morals. So Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam looks at the young man and says, hang on, come here. Would you like it for your sister? He says, no, I wouldn't, not at all. Would you like it for your mother? Someone does it. He says, no. Would you like it for your daughter? No. Well, they are all sisters and mothers and daughters of someone. So how would you? He says, I understand. I will not do this. Wallahi, I will never do this. Amazing. Today the West is teaching us something after they have slid into difficulty. But we have the ingredient from a long time ago. The Muslims lead a disciplined life. So disciplined that subhanAllah, if you are to follow true Islam, your problems will be minimized. Nobody's saying you won't have issues and problems. Those are tests from Allah. But they will not come in as a punishment. You will understand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is testing. Amazing. So let me say something. Something very, very important. Islam has the solution to your problem. The problem with us is we don't want to follow the solution. Imagine the doctor tells you, you need to drink this. It's a little bit bitter, but you need to have it morning, afternoon, evening. In fact, let me make it more interesting. The doctor says, you want to really be cured from this huge disease you have. You need to get up at 15 minutes past 2 every morning and have 5 spoons of this. Wallahi, you'll be getting up at 13 minutes past 2 and waiting another 2 minutes. As soon as it clicks 15, you'll be drinking it because you want cure. We need cure for the diseases of the heart. Salah is the beginning point, together with istighfar and asking Allah's forgiveness. Ask Allah's forgiveness. He loves you.